Many people have asked me to do a video on auto rotation in Arma. My TTB2 guide details this to an extent, and there's a section in my Cobra course that talks about it as well. Still, there's a few additional things to say, so I thought I'd make a quick video on it. In reality, auto rotation works on the premise of keeping your rotor blades spinning after the engine power has been lost, and then using that stored energy at the last moment to arrest your descent and allow for landing. Arma more or less gets this right, but it does have some dangerous quirks you need to be aware of. Keep in mind that auto-rotation in Arma is harder than an Ace, so if you can do an Arma auto-rotation, you can do an Ace one. In Arma, the instant you hear your engine dying, or you see the engine damage indicator go red, press and hold down collective. You'll hold this throughout the remainder of your flight. Simultaneously, get your aircraft as level as possible. This is essential. If you don't do this, if your nose is pitched down even a pinch too much, you'll probably die. Once you're level, you can do one of two things. One, you can use whatever speed you had to keep flying forward. You can also turn slightly in the process. Or you can reduce your speed if you're at too low of a level or you don't want to overfly a potential landing zone. Once you're leveled out and ascending, do a hasty scan for an LZ. A slight curving path in the direction that you're sitting in the helicopter can help to reveal potential LZs as you're descending. You'll see here that I've noticed a road which I can reasonably assume will be clear to land in. Now, due to the quirks of Arma's auto-rotation, I can't pitch my nose down or do too many dramatic maneuvers without spoiling the attempt. Ace is different in that respect, but we're not showing Ace right now. As you're descending, continue trying to assess the LZ as best you can. Slow your forward speed as you descend. Landing at a high forward speed is to be avoided. It's typically fatal. Keep in mind that since there's no vortex ring state in Arma, you can actually auto-rotate straight down if the situation requires. Now, once you're 30 meters or so above ground level, release down collective and hold up collective. This will take that stored energy in the rotor system and give you enough thrust to set down lightly. When setting down, do your best to land as level as you can. Striking the tail first in Arma can do an incredible amount of damage to the aircraft, and if you've already taken damage to the engine, they can easily result in an explosion. Now that quirk mentioned earlier comes into play when pitching your nose down after losing engine power. Auto-rotation in Arma requires the aircraft to be fairly level, with very low tolerance for deviation. If you pitch too far forward, you'll see the rotor spin down, and even if you try to correct it like you see here, you'll almost certainly run into one of two things. Either the aircraft will no longer be able to pitch up, like you're seeing here, or, as in this situation, even after pitching up, you'll be in too fast of a descent to stop. Actually, I guess technically you'll run into something else as well, because the ground's going to be in your immediate future, and you're not going to like it. Anyway, to rehash the points, as soon as you lose engine, immediately drop collective, level out, find an LZ, drift towards it, slow your forward speed as you reach the LZ, when you're 30 meters above the ground, do full up collective, and try to land as level as you can. If you do all those steps, 99 times out of 100, you'll be just fine. So, that concludes Art of Flight 5. Best of luck out there.